Well, as you heard in that report, Valéry Giscard d'Estaing was a key architect of the modern European Union. Our Brussels correspondent Dave Keating gave us reaction to his death from around the EU.
Well, the reaction from EU leaders is just starting to come in this morning. Council President Charles Michel just posted on Twitter that Giscard was a modernizer of France, which made France fully play a leading role in Europe and made the dream of a more integrated Europe a reality. He created the European Council, which laid the foundations of monetary union and therefore the euro. It is true that his time as president saw a major transformation of the trajectory of the European Union, as well at the same time as he was changing the trajectory of France. He is well regarded here in Brussels, to say the least, because he was so passionately pro-European throughout his career. After he left office, he served as a member of the European Parliament here from 1989 to 1993. But he is perhaps best known here for his role as president of the Convention on the Future of the European Union. That was the constitutional convention that ran in the early 2000s to devise the European Constitution. Now, that famously went on to be rejected by French voters in 2005. Despite Giscard campaigning for it so passionately, his countrymen rejected the Constitution. It was retooled into the Lisbon Treaty, which is the legal framework that the EU is still operating under today. So this legacy is quite poignant at the moment, actually, because there's a new convention happening now. It's called the Conference on the Future of Europe. This was current president, French President Macron's idea. It's his baby. But they don't dare call it a constitutional convention because of that experience in 2005. They don't want to use any of those types of words. But I think what we're going to see today is some EU leaders saying, look, Giscard was bold. He didn't mind calling it a constitution or a convention. We need bolder leaders today who more passionately embrace the European project.
That's our Brussels correspondent, Dave.